I'd like to welcome you to our System for Award Management Entity Registration Training webinar, which provides step-by-step guidance on registering your entity, be it a business, individual, or organization, in the System for Award Management, also known as SAM.gov. This is the second in a series of webinars providing information for those entities interested in applying for the Shuttered Venue Operators Grant Program, also known as SVOG. Registration in SAM is a requirement for entities applying for Shuttered Venue Operators Grants. First, we'll cover what SAM.gov is and why registration in this system is required. Then, we'll walk you step-by-step through the application process, including applying for and receiving a DUNS number, creating a login.gov account, and then, finally, registering your entity in SAM. At the end of today's session, we'll discuss additional resources available to you to assist you with the process. SAM registration is a straightforward process. Following these steps will help you get your entity registered as efficiently as possible, so you're ready for the SVOG program application. The System for Award Management is an online portal where entities, including people or organizations, register in order to do business with the federal government. This includes grant recipients. To apply for the SVO grant program, entities must have an active SAM registration. If you have an existing registration, you may need to update that registration, as this is a requirement to maintain an active registration. There is no fee to register in SAM. The SAM system is used by the federal government to provide a common platform to capture entity data for grants official use. This includes a wide range of entity information, including the entity's unique entity identifier, banking information, taxpayer ID number, and CAGE code. SAM entity registration also provides a repository for entities to make common representations and certifications necessary for the grant-making process. Finally, the SAM system is used to validate entity uniqueness, supporting integrity of the database of registered entities. The first step in the process is creating a DUNS number. To do this, you'll navigate to fedgov.dnb.com/webform. This is the site where you can search for an existing DUNS number or obtain a new one. Once you've navigated to the site, you'll follow the on-screen instructions to check whether your business or organization already has a DUNS number. This process entails entering your business name and state and the validation text. If your business is listed, you can request the existing DUNS number. If it is not, you can request a new one. This is a quick process. New DUNS numbers can be created in a day. Note, there is no fee for getting a DUNS number in order to do business with the U.S. government. When creating a new DUNS number, first you'll need to gather your entity's documentation. Registration requires at least two forms of acceptable documentation. The full list of acceptable documents is provided in the DUNS number request workflow and includes documents like a Secretary of State Articles of Incorporation, your Taxpayer Identification Number Confirmation Letter, your Employer Identification Number Confirmation Letter, lease agreements, and utility bills. Remember, these documents must clearly show the correct legal business name and current physical address. For sole proprietors, the documents must include your full legal name and current physical address. Next, you'll submit your DUNS number request. During this step, you'll upload the supporting documentation. I cannot emphasize enough the importance of being attentive to detail to ensure that the information you enter is correct. That includes spelling, business names, etc. Once you've submitted your DUNS number request, it should be issued to you within a business day. The next step in the SAM registration process is creating a login.gov user account. Login.gov provides secure and private online access to multiple government services and applications. With a login.gov account, you can sign into multiple government websites with the same username and password. You'll need to create a login.gov user account, which you can do from the SAM.gov website by selecting Login and Create an Account. During the process, you'll provide your email address and create a password. You'll also need to provide a mobile phone number. login.gov uses two-factor authentication and provides six-digit codes via text message to your phone. These codes authenticate the individual logging into the login.gov account to provide for improved account security. Once you've established your login.gov account and secured your DUNS number, you're ready to register your entity in SAM. When you're registering an entity in SAM.gov, the first question you'll need to answer is, why are you registering? In the context of the SVO grant program, you're looking to apply for federal assistance opportunities like grants, loans, and other financial assistance programs. This sets you on the path to registration that matches with the assistance you're looking to secure. When you register, you'll input information related to your entity, you'll be asked to make certain representations and certifications, and at the end of the process, you'll be asked to submit a notarized letter for new entity administrators. This slide includes some of the information you'll be required to provide. Now, let's get to the process itself. First, go to www.sam.gov in your browser and log in using your login.gov account. On this page, click the icon for Entity Registration, and on the next page, Register New Entity. At this point, you'll be asked to select your type of entity. For most businesses, nonprofits, and sole proprietors, you'll select business or organization as your entity. Next, for accessing federal financial assistance only, you'll select, I only want to apply for federal assistance opportunities like grants, loans, and other financial assistance programs. In response to the question, why are you registering this entity to do business with the U.S. government? This sets you on the streamlined path to entity registration. The SAM system will then walk you through a series of steps to enter what is referred to as core data. This covers a number of different topics that I'll cover here. First, you'll validate your DUNS information. The system will compare what's in the entity's DUNS data with the information you've entered in SAM. For example, entity name and physical address. It's very important to make sure that what you enter in SAM is exactly the same as what you've entered in DUNS. Next, you'll enter business information. This includes your business start date, fiscal year-end close date, and where you create your MPIN, Marketing Partner Identification Number. The MPIN acts as a password in other government systems while also serving as your signature for your consent to disclosure of tax information to the IRS. Finally, you'll enter your tax identification number, which is generally your employer ID number or Social Security number, depending on your business structure, and sign the consent to disclosure of tax information with your MPIN. The consent to disclosure is where you authorize the Internal Revenue Service to validate and disclose to the SAM program office whether the name and taxpayer identification number provided for this registration matches the name and TIN maintained in the IRS files for your entity for the most current tax year reported. After the IRS consent form, you're guided next to the CAGE code part of the registration. If you already have a CAGE code, you enter it here. If you do not, the system will request one for you upon submission of your entity registration. Be aware that it may take up to 10 days after you submit your SAM registration to receive the CAGE code. Next, you provide additional business and banking information. This includes your bank name, account number, and routing number. Following the business and banking information sections, you'll be asked to provide information regarding executive compensation if your entity meets the following two criteria. First, that 80% or more of your annual revenues consist of U.S. federal contracts, grants, and loans. Second, that your entity receives $25 million or more in annual gross revenues from U.S. federal contracts, grants, and loans. The final step of core data entry is the proceedings section. Once you're complete with the core data section, you'll complete the points of contact section. Your electronic business POC, or point of contact, is integral to any grants.gov registration and application process. Your government business POC will be used by other government systems, such as the CAGE program, when they contact you. Make sure you list someone with direct knowledge of this registration for both of these POCs. The last step before submitting your registration is completion of the representations and certifications. Here you'll review the following. Does your business wish to apply for a federal financial assistance project or program? Or is your business currently the recipient of funding under any federal financial assistance project or program? Select yes or no as appropriate. If you select yes, then you will see the corresponding financial assistance, general certifications, and representations text. Once you review the grants, certifications, and representations, you will need to attest to the accuracy of your entity registration. The last step in the SAM registration process is to make sure to select submit after your final review. You will get a registration submitted confirmation message on the screen. If you do not see this message, you have not submitted your registration. Once submitted, your registration will be reviewed. You will receive an email from SAM.gov when your registration is active. To finalize your entity registration, you are required to submit a notarized letter to grant access to new entity administrators. This is required within 60 days of your SAM registration submission. The notarized letter process is straightforward, and there are templates available to ensure you've got the correct language for your letter. The process is fully explained in a knowledge base article provided on the technical support site for SAM.gov. This site is the Federal Support Desk at www.fsd.gov. Use of this site is at no cost to you, the user. You can find this knowledge base article by navigating to www.fsd.gov. Search the knowledge base for K as in Kilo, B as in Bravo, 0016652, titled, How Can I Become the New Administrator for Our Entity Registration? When you find this article, it will explain exactly what information is required and provide letter templates, including one for a single entity and one for multiple domestic entities. Once you've generated the letter on your letterhead, have the letter notarized, scanned, and submitted to the FSD. The mechanics of the letter submission are found in the knowledge base article referenced earlier. So that's it. You've made it through the process. New registrations do take 7 to 10 days to process as your information is validated. There are resources to assist you as you navigate this process. For login.gov user account creation, see the link on this slide. This video, created by the General Services Administration, provides the step-by-step process to create your account. I'd also recommend the SAM Registration Handbook for non-federal users. This can be found on SAM.gov under the Help tab. It will walk you step-by-step through the registration process and answer many of the questions you may have. It's a tremendous resource. For technical assistance and to upload your notarized letter, please visit the Federal Service Desk at www.fsd.gov or by telephone at 866-606-8220. Should you have difficulty securing your DUNS number, Dun & Bradstreet maintains a helpline at 844-542-6070. Last but not least, there are many local assistance resources available to support you. These include your local SBA district office, and a network of SBA-funded partners, including the Small Business Development Center Network, SCORE, and Women's Business Centers. These organizations provide no-cost technical assistance and business counseling. You can find your closest resource at www.sba.gov/local-assistance. These are tremendous resources and can help you with the SAM process or any other business challenges you may face. While this is the end of this session, there's a great deal of information to come. We recommend you visit www.sba.gov/SVOG regularly for the latest information on the SVOG program, including frequently asked questions and details on additional training sessions that will provide further clarity around the Shuttered Venue Operators Grant Program, eligibility, and application process. Thank you for joining us. We'll talk to you soon.